Now, today's lesson is on dialogic orientation quadrant. So this is a powerful model developed by Dr. Haesan Moon from University of Toronto back in 2017. So now, this model allows the OKR coach like yourself to understand your team, employees, and your coachee, and your client better in terms of where they are and the situations that they are in and where they want to be with regards to their performance. Now, DOQ is a useful tool to start a coaching conversation and it provides insights on your client's frame of mind and perception. Now, DOQ is a great learning tool when used for observation and reflection. Now, as an OKR coach, you constantly have to deal with your staff's in performance issues. You need to guide them, you need to coach them, and you need to motivate them towards achieving the key results. Now, by using the concept of DOQ, you are not only able to understand where they are heading, their preferred future, but you are also be able to help them to look at things that they have worked for them in the past. You know, you could also learn from their past mistakes and understand the consequences of remaining at status quo and not achieving the key results. So that's why understanding the concept of DOQ is important for us as an OKR coach so that we are able to help our staff to have a clearer picture of the situation that they are in and where and what they can do differently to move towards their goals by leveraging on their strength. Now, let's take a look at the DOQ. First, the X-axis represents the horizontal timeline. Towards the right is the future and towards the left is in the past. Now, the Y or the content axis is the vertical line represent the positive and the negative stuff. So the positive or the good stuff is what people want to see continue, more of, increase or grow in their life. The opposite end is the not so good stuff that people want less of. Okay, so now you have the four quadrants now. So we call it quadrant one as positive future, quadrant two as positive past, and quadrant three is the negative past, and quadrant four is the negative future. So if we all put all these four quadrants in a proper boxes, so we label Q1 as preferred future, Q2 as the resourceful past, and Q3 as troubled past, and Q4 as dreaded future. Now, when you strike a conversation with your team regarding their performance or the situation that they are in, you can start mapping their responses based on this DOQ model. So it may not be as clear-cut when mapping their responses, but I promise you it will be a rewarding and fruitful effort for you if you do so. All right? So because it will guide and orient your team towards more of what they want and what they care about and also what's important for them in their life. Now, when you strike a conversation with your team regarding their performance or the situations that they are in, you can always start mapping the response based on this DOQ model. So it may not be as clear-cut when you are mapping their responses, but I promise you it will be a rewarding and fruitful effort for you if you do so, right? So because it will guide or orient your team towards more of what they want, what they really care about, and what's important for them. Now, in this way, your team will have a better clarity on what needs to be done, and now they are motivated to go all out to give their best to achieve their objective and key results. Now, it's practice time again, and I want you to take a moment to think about the questions that you can ask in each of these four quadrants. Now, here are some of the questions you can actually ask in each of this quadrant, right? There could be a situation where your coachee is not ready to talk about quadrant one and quadrant two, and they just want to talk about quadrant three and quadrant four instead. So what do you do in this situation? Well, we just acknowledge, right? While we do not ignore or avoid quadrant three and quadrant four, we will not dwell too much or more than needed on the details because they are not very useful and it may lead to problem talks. So what we can do is to start taking relevant questions to guide their thinking to focus on the positive, resourceful past and orient them towards their preferred future.